Monkey decided to learn everything online, and Monkey has been learning for 6 hours straight. 3 videos on how to stay focused, 2 on how to wake up early, 1 guy bathing in ice water claiming it cured his laziness, and 1 Montauk Monkey didn't understand, but still commented, "Great." Now Monkey has 27 unfinished courses, 50 Montube playlists, and 101 motivational videos saved for someday. Each time Monkey opens Montube, Monkey swears it's for learning. But an hour later, Monkey's deep in a rabbit hole titled, 10 Signs You're Secretly a Genius, Number 7 Will Blow Your Mind. After all that, Monkey still hasn't learned a thing. So, what happened? Monkey isn't lazy. Monkey is trapped, and the trap has a name, the algorithm. Number 1. Monkey's Brain versus the Internet. Monkey's brain was built for hunting bananas, not for scrolling endless playlists. In the jungle, monkey's learning worked like this. Monkey sees another monkey open a banana. Monkey copies. Monkey eats banana. Success. That's called real feedback. Monkey does something, sees the result, adjusts, and learns. But online, monkey watches someone else do it on Montube and thinks, "Yeah, I could totally do that." Then monkey closes the laptop and forgets everything. Once, monkey watched how to meditate for inner peace. 15 minutes later, monkey was yelling at the Wi-Fi for being too slow. Watching is not learning. Monkey's brain evolved to learn by doing, not by watching. Monkey confuses information exposure with skill acquisition, a mistake called the illusion of competence, and the algorithm profits from that illusion. Number 2. The algorithm's trap. So, who exactly is this mysterious algorithm? Algorithm isn't a teacher. Algorithm isn't a friend. Algorithm is like a sneaky waiter who keeps bringing snacks monkey didn't order, just because monkey once looked hungry. Algorithm's job is simple. Keep monkey's eyes on the screen, not to make monkey smarter, not to help monkey finish a course, just keep monkey watching. Monkey opens Montube to learn HTML. Algorithm says, "Oh, monkey wants web development." Then comes a tutorial, then another, then a funnier one, then top 10 mistakes beginner developers make, then why HTML is dead, then React developer salaries in 2025. Now, monkey's learning journey has turned into a career crisis, an existential crisis, and finally, a cat playing piano. Algorithm wins. Monkey forgets why monkey even opened Montube. Number 3. Why algorithm always wins. Algorithm studies monkey better than monkey studies anything. It knows when monkey pauses, skips, rewinds, or clicks away. It measures monkey's attention like a banana tracker. Monkey replays a funny moment. Algorithm learns monkey likes humor. Monkey skips a long lecture. Algorithm decides monkey hates deep learning. So it feeds monkey more quick, easy, dopamine-packed content. Monkey ends up feeling productive, but learning nothing. Algorithm rewards entertainment, not education. Monkey wants to learn Python, but algorithm shows Python memes compilation. Algorithm promotes what keeps monkey engaged, not what helps monkey grow. In other words, algorithm gives monkey sugar, not vegetables. And monkey's brain, of course, prefers sugar. Who wouldn't want 10 tricks to become a genius instead of understanding memory systems step by step? Monkey keeps eating mental candy and calls it studying. And worst of all, monkey thinks that's progress. Monkey's brain can't fight infinite choices. Once upon a time, monkey chose between one tree and another. Now monkey must choose between 10,000 courses, 5 million videos, and 200 gurus screaming opposite advice. Too many bananas. Monkey freezes. When monkey can't choose, monkey scrolls. And scrolling feels like progress, but it's just movement in disguise. Number 4. The loop of fake learning. The illusion of progress. Monkey proudly says, "I watched 10 hours of coding tutorials this week," but monkey never opened the code editor once. That's like watching gym videos while eating chips. Monkey's brain thinks it exercised, because fake progress gives the same dopamine hit as real progress, just cheaper. Monkey watched, learn Photoshop in 1 hour. After 1 hour, Monkey learned exactly one thing. The instructor's accent is cool. Every new skill video gives a tiny dose of validation. Monkey feels smart until Monkey actually tries to do something. Then everything collapses, because watching progress does not mean making progress, and the algorithm knows that perfectly well. The feedback problem. When Monkey learns from a real teacher, Monkey gets instant feedback. Monkey, that's wrong. Try again. Monkey fixes the mistake, learns, improves. Online, Monkey clicks, submit quiz. Algorithm says, incorrect. Try again. Monkey clicks random answers until the green check appears. Algorithm doesn't teach Monkey. It just rewards completion. Not for understanding, just for finishing. Slowly, Monkey's brain learns the wrong formula. Click, reward, success. Not understand, apply, grow. Algorithm isn't teaching Monkey to think. It's teaching Monkey to react. It's like training a monkey to press a button for bananas. Monkey becomes faster at pressing buttons, not smarter. Monkey's emotional trap. Monkey's not addicted to learning. Monkey's addicted to feeling like learning. Algorithm knows Monkey's emotions better than Monkey's mom. Feeling tired? Algorithm whispers, "This video will change your life." Feeling ambitious? Algorithm serves, "How to make $10,000 a month." Feeling curious? Algorithm shows, "The secret habits of millionaires." Monkey feels inspired for 5 minutes. Then Monkey scrolls to the next one. Algorithm has discovered the perfect drug, motivation without movement. Monkey watches a discipline video. Dopamine rises. Monkey does nothing. Dopamine drops. So Monkey watches another and another. Monkey's not chasing knowledge anymore. Monkey's chasing the chemical rush of self-improvement content. Monkey calls it personal growth. Algorithm calls it high retention. Eventually, Monkey's brain stops asking, "What did I learn?" and starts asking, "What should I watch next to feel better about not learning?" Monkey becomes addicted to the idea of progress, not progress itself. Algorithm sells motivation. Monkey buys illusion. And the loop continues. Number 5. The biology behind Monkey's struggle. Let's peek inside Monkey's head. There's a tiny chemical called dopamine. It says, "That felt good. Do it again." Every new thumbnail, every next video, triggers a mini dopamine burst. Monkey's brain celebrates, even when Monkey hasn't learned anything. Real learning, though. No dopamine, just frustration. Monkey's brain hates frustration. Algorithm knows this, so it removes frustration completely. Monkey's brain starts confusing pleasure with progress. Click is reward. Struggle is punishment. So Monkey keeps clicking, scrolling, and feeling productive while learning nothing. Deep work feels like failure, and failure doesn't trend. At some point, Monkey stops learning and starts collecting information. Monkey becomes a content curator of unprocessed ideas. Monkey says, "I know a lot about psychology." But when asked, Monkey can only quote memes. Monkey knows everything about everything, but nothing deeply. Monkey's brain is like a tab-filled browser, full but useless. Algorithm made learning feel like Netflix. Monkey now binges knowledge, but remembers none of it. Monkey's brain isn't broken, it's just been hacked. And the algorithm? It didn't even need to try that hard. Number 6. The side effects. Burnout, doubt, and banana depression. Monkey starts feeling tired. Monkey has watched hundreds of videos but sees no improvement. Monkey blames Monkey. "I'm just not disciplined. I'm too stupid for coding." But Monkey's not stupid, just stuck in a system designed for engagement, not education. Every time Monkey gives up, algorithm wins again. Monkey starts another beginner's guide video. The cycle repeats. Number 7. The rebuild. How Monkey outsmarts the algorithm. Step 1. One small goal. Monkey stops saying, "I'll learn it in 3 months." Instead, Monkey says, "I'll build one web page today." Algorithm doesn't know what to do with that. Monkey isn't watching. Monkey's doing. Monkey opens a code editor, writes one line, breaks it, fixes it, and learns more from one bug than from 10 tutorials. Monkey feels something new. Not dopamine. Progress. Step 2. create a private environment. Monkey realizes algorithm can't tempt what it can't reach. Monkey disables autoplay, blocks recommendations, opens videos manually, one at a time. Now monkey chooses what to learn, not algorithm. The jungle of distraction becomes a quiet study cave. Monkey sets timers, turns off notifications, and tracks progress on sticky notes. Each finished project is a banana reward. Step 3. Find real feedback. Monkey returns to how learning used to work. When monkey makes a mistake, someone points it out. Monkey learns, adapts, improves. Painful? Yes. Effective? Absolutely. Monkey remembers, embarrassment is data. Every correction builds skill. Monkey also finds another way to get feedback, without relying on strangers or the algorithm. Monkey discovers Brilliant, a learning app that doesn't show answers. It makes monkey figure them out. Brilliant helps monkey become a better thinker and problem solver, with thousands of visual, interactive lessons in math, science, programming, data analysis, and AI. Each lesson feels like a mini jungle puzzle. Monkey clicks, tests, fails, and learns by doing. It's like giving monkey's neurons a gym membership. That's active learning, proven to be up to 6 times more effective than passive watching. Within a week, monkey's brain enjoys the struggle again. That's the real victory. Monkey's dopamine is now tied to solving, not scrolling. If you want to train your brain like monkey, you can start for free at brilliant.org/monkeymind101. Scan the QR code or click the link in the description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription, which gives you unlimited daily access to everything. Now, back to the next step. Step 4. Track results, not watch time. Monkey stops counting how many videos monkey watched. Instead, monkey counts what monkey built. One web page finished, one design made, one idea explained to another monkey. Monkey learns that progress is measurable, but only by output, not input. Algorithm can't gamify that. And for the first time, monkey feels something stronger than motivation. Momentum. Step 5. Protect monkey's focus. Monkey learns that attention is a resource. Every time algorithm wins a click, monkey loses a thought. So monkey guards focus like bananas in a storm. Scheduled breaks, silent notifications, single task sessions. Monkey trains the brain like a muscle. Rest, lift, repeat. Focus returns. Clarity follows. Monkey feels human again, or at least a smarter monkey. Number 8. Monkey tames the algorithm. The algorithm starts to panic. Why isn't monkey clicking? Why is monkey ignoring my recommendations? Monkey isn't ignoring. Monkey's sending new signals, watching full lectures, pausing to take notes, searching for deeper explanations. Algorithm pauses, thinks, monkey wants quality. And slowly, the algorithm starts suggesting better content. Monkey realizes, monkey can't escape the algorithm, but monkey can train it. The algorithm isn't evil, it's just efficient. It gives monkey what monkey clicks, not what monkey needs. In the end, monkey learns the biggest lesson of all. Learning online isn't about finding better algorithms. It's about becoming a better learner. Monkey can't outsmart the algorithm by being faster, only by being more intentional. So next time monkey opens the laptop, monkey remembers, the goal isn't to watch. The goal is to understand. The goal isn't to finish courses. The goal is to apply lessons. Sometimes monkey still gets distracted because monkey is, well, monkey. Algorithm still runs the internet, but monkey runs monkey's mind. The monkey says thanks, like this video? Toss him a subscribe, it keeps the bananas coming.